Well, hi, because maybe it's not morning. Maybe it's not morning when you're watching this. I'm Summer. Welcome to Power Life Live. This is Power Sculpt Express. You guys, I've not had my coffee yet. It is morning. I don't know what's happening. But I know Lindsay's here to play with us today. Lindsay. And we'll get started a little bit differently. So you need a set of weights, your mat. Click play on your playlist in like a hot second. Come onto your mat. Come on your back. Find Supta Baddha Konasana, please. This is where you click play on your playlist, right? Before you get too cozy. To touch, think prayer feet, if that were a thing. Of your feet into your mat. Allow your knees to splay open like a book. Feel a stretch through your hip, your inner thigh. If you put one hand on your belly, one hand on your heart. So I previously told you guys about our first camping excursion. We bought a camper. It's been sitting in storage since March, and it was a hot mess. It was a hot mess, but we got through it, and we camped again this last weekend, and my husband and I were giving each other, like, knuckle bumps and high fives like it was our job, because setting up, so much smoother. Tearing down took, like, a fraction of the time, and, like, we packed all the things. Like, it got dark out, and we were like, okay, we had lanterns. We had a fire already. We had dinner ready before it was, like, pitch black. We were just winning. So it's funny to me how, like, surprised I was knowing that once you get, like, one session under your belt or, like, you practice something or you do something more than one time, you get better at it. Like, why is that surprising? Because I think about my practice on my mat, and it's not, like, a distinct night and day. It's not like, oh, one day I can't do push-ups and the next I can. It's more gradual. So I want you to take this moment to just check in with your body, check in with your breath, know that your first down dog, when you're like, down what, why is this hard, is a long time behind you. Even if it was last week, you would become more efficient and better and stronger with every practice. Take a big breath in. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, your fingertips behind your ears. Just keep them here for now. Press the knife edge of your feet into your mat. Squeeze the bottoms of your feet together, frog pumps with a pulse. Inhale, lower, tuck your tailbone under. Exhale, press your knife edge of your feet into your mat, squeeze your hips to the ceiling and pulse. Lower, lift, pulse. Lower, lift, and pulse. Lower, lift, pulse. Lower, lift, pulse. Keep going. You're just like, why? Why am I in this recorded class? I promise this is the weirdest thing we're going to do, but you don't have to worry about it because you're at home. Lindsay's here in, like, all of cyberspace. Be like, okay, we're frog pumping. We're frog pumping. But here's the deal, you guys. This is amazing for your backside. Not only are we starting with glute activation so that you can turn your bottom on so you can use it more efficiently throughout class, but it's for your shelf. Your, like, upper butt cheek, like, little bit of lift, a little bit of tightness. Everybody wants that. It's good for everybody. You've got a few more here. Just for funsies, hug your belly up and in. Everything is tight. Squeeze your glutes to the ceiling and then pulse when you come to the top. Lower down, lift, find a slight pulse. Crunch. In three, two, lower your hips, crunch. Lower your head, neck, and shoulders, lift your hips. Lower, crunch. Lower, frog pump. Lower. Crunch, lower, lift your hips, lower, head, neck, and shoulders, lower, lift your hips. Keep going. We just alternate. Okay, now we've got some core activation as well. Splay your knees and elbows wide as you squeeze to the ceiling with your hips. Again, it's squeezing your glutes. With the crunch, I want you to lead with your chest. Press your chest to the ceiling. Allow your head, neck, and shoulders to sort of follow the movement. Pull your belly up and in. So good, Lindsay. She's like, dear God, get me out of this. Not because it's hard, because it's awkward. Same at home, sure is. But look at it this way, Lindsay. You don't, like, have, like, dog hair all over you. Like, at home, that'd be a whole other thing. I'd have, like, a snout in my face, like, nowhere near getting the activation we're looking for. Few more. We move to Supta crunches with our legs. Last three. Two. Last one, glue the knife edge of your feet into your mat. Tuck your tailbone under. Big breath in. Exhale, crunch. Lift your feet to the ceiling as well as your chest. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Lower. Crunch it up. Lower. Crunch. Lower. Lift your chest. Lift your feet. So really, you're curling your tailbone under. curl your tailbone under. As you crunch, you're working your entire abdominal wall. So you've got like your upper abs like right beneath your rib cage, but also your lowers, the area below your waistband. It's got a few nicknames. We'll just skip them all because not one of them is nice, but we're all leaving with a V cut. That's where we're going with this. Continue to spread your knees wide. I know it's awkward. I know it's weird. We're doing it anyway. How you doing, Lindsay?
I'm good.
Just living her best life. Just living her best life. Five more. Pulse at the top and pulse. In three, two, pulse it here. Pulse up, up, up. Drive your navel to your spine. Dig it into your mat. Now lift both shoulder blades up off your mat. Oh, God. I know. Splay your elbows wide. You can't see them in your peripheral. Last three. Two. Roll to your right hip for a modified forearm side plank. Come to your right hip. Bring your left hand behind your ears again. Hip dip clamshell. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift up. Press your feet into each other. Lift your hip off the ground. Close your legs. Squeeze them up. Close them and squeeze. Close them and squeeze. You should feel some work in your abductor, your right side booty. All of your body weight on your hip. You push it up by squeezing and opening up your knees. Squeeze your hips up. Open your knees. Squeeze them up. Open your knees. I'm still in like prayer feet. Prayer feet's a thing today. Parallel your forearm at the top of your mat for more stability. Four, three, two. Stay on your hip. Extend your bottom leg long. Reach your top arm up. Cross body toe touch. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift and twist. Lower, lift and twist. Lower, lift and twist. Lower, lift, twist. Get a little bit of inner thigh. Also obliques. If you want a little more challenge, bring your leg further in front. How you doing, Lindsay?
Good.
Just doing the weird stuff. Just doing all the weird stuff. Last four. Three. Two. Come back to your back. Wide bridge this time. Heel toe your feet to the edge of your mat, that your heels are on the edges of your mat. Dig through your heels, tuck your tailbone under, squeeze your glutes to the ceiling. We've got singles with a pulse. You pulse, lower, lift, pulse, lower, lift, pulse at the top, lower, lift, pulse, lower, lift, pulse. Keep going. Spread your knees apart. So engage through your side booty. Press them apart and continue to drive your knees out as you pulse up. This is why your feet are out wide. You can stack your knees over your ankles. Again, the focus here is to pinch your backside. Even though you're squeezing through your glutes, your hamstrings will be like, oof-da. That's on purpose. The pulse is just for good measure. It's just for a little more activation. Are you squeezing your glutes in the top? Well, you have to for the pulse. A few more. We'll alternate. We'll add a crunch in three, two, squeeze it up, lower your hips, crunch through, and lower. Squeeze your hips up, lower, lift your chest, crunch through, lower. Hips, chest, hips, chest. Keep going. Both shoulder blades off your mat. Lift them up. Get a little more oblique love in about 8 seconds. Exaggerate this movement, make it bigger. We haven't even gotten up yet. You are prime, prep, ready. You are fresh. You are laying on your back. Five. Last three. Two. Hold your crunch. Alternate heel touches. Touch your right heel, your left. Crunch through the right, through your left. Oblique love. Bring your rib and hip closer together. Squeeze them together. So maybe you don't just touch the edge of your heel, the outside of your heel. Maybe you touch the top of your foot. Continue to squeeze. Anchor your lower back into your mat. You get a lovely massage here as your shoulders lift up and you round and shimmy your lower back on the ground. Five. Last four. Three, two, Roll to your left forearm, modified side plank. Bring your knees to touch. Hip lift clamshells. Inhale here, exhale, lift your hips, open your legs, lower and lift, lower, lift. Touch your hip to the ground, squeeze it up. Touch down, squeeze it up. You're pressing into the outside edge of your knee, squeezing through your abductors, both of them. Your bottom abductor, your left, is gonna be screaming. Put all of your body weight into your knee, into your lower body, out of your forearm. This is here for stability and balance only.
You feeling this on your booty yet?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, good. Like your hip. Last three. Two. Last one, hold it low. Extend your bottom leg, cross body toe touch. Inhale to reach, exhale to crunch. Reach, lift, reach, lift, reach, lift. Again, for more challenge, bring your leg out in front. You feel your inner thighs like, whoo. Open up, twist and touch. You've got it. 8 seconds here. We get to move on, do some normal stuff. But what I love about starting on the floor is, one, it's a different way to warm up. But two, it's also a way to turn on your glutes and your abs you can use in the rest of class. So we're all about activating muscles, creating some mind-muscle connection, and then being more efficient with our time. So again, with practice, we get more efficient. We get better. We get stronger. Five. Last three. Two, roll to your back, hug your knees to your chest. Ooh. Rock and roll forward and back. Build some momentum. Meet me in high plank. Well, forward fold. Forward fold, that's way nicer. Forward fold, top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Press your hands into your shins, flatten your back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, mountain pose, breathe here. Stack one vertebra on top of the next. Glide your shoulders away from your ears. Turn your pinkies in to broaden the backside of your body. Big breath in. Exhale, mini back bend. Breathe here. Cactus your arms. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Shine your chest forward. Exhale. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, mountain pose. Exhale, mini back bend. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, chaturanga. Lower to a mid plank. Graze your elbows along your rib cage. Inhale, upward facing dog. Press the tops of your feet into your mat. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a big breath in here. Find a few pedals if you need them. It's the first time you've been in one today. Likely, likely. I mean, I don't know what you do when you get up. Inhale, bend your knees, look forward. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, please. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose, breathe here. Send all of your body weight into your heels. See, lift, wiggle your toes. Now tuck your tailbone under, engage through your lower belly. Big breath in. Exhale, chair, airplane arms, breathe here. Nothing changes through your legs. Squeeze your palms above your hips and then together. Exhale. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Inhale your right leg high, please. Three-legged dog. Exhale, low lunge. Breathe here. Step your foot in between your hands. Stack your front knee over your front ankle. Squeeze your back hamstring towards the ceiling. Exhale. Inhale, crescent lunge. Breathe here. Maintain a 90-degree bend in your front knee. Roll your back heel up over your toes. Bend your back knee slightly to square your hips forward. Big breath in. Exhale, warrior two. Breathe here. Parallel the back edge of your foot with the back of your mat. Now press the knife edge of it. We've been using this for front pumps in the same spot. Now stack your shoulders over your hips. Reach through your fingers. Exhale. Inhale, reverse warrior. Breathe here. Keep your legs the same. Lengthen through both sides of your body and then reach back. Big breath in. Exhale, chaturanga, windmill down. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Inhale, your left leg high, three-legged dog. Exhale, low lunge. Breathe here. Set it back up. Parallel your front hamstring with your mat. Pull your belly off your leg. Exhale. Inhale, crescent lunge. Breathe here. Again, bend your back knee. to roll your heel up over your toes and square your hips forward. Glide your shoulders away from your ears. Squeeze your biceps behind them. Big breath in. Exhale, warrior two. Breathe here. Press through the knife edge of your back. Lock that leg out. Now sink your hips in line with your knees. Reach to the crown of your head. Exhale. Inhale, reverse warrior. Breathe here. Again, sink down. Lengthen through both sides body, then lead back. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. So good, friends. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. We'll flow one time with our weights. Inhale, bend your knees, look forward. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, no weights. Exhale, fold, grab your dumbbells. Inhale, chair pose, press them in at heart center. Exhale, chair airplane arms, squeeze them above your hips. Inhale, chair pose, heart center. Exhale, forward fold, ditch them. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Inhale, your right leg high. Exhale, low lunge. Grab your dumbbells. Inhale, crescent lunge. Shoot them straight above your shoulders. Exhale, warrior two. Pull them through heart center. Micro bend through your elbows. Inhale, reverse. Punch your weight straight above your shoulder. There is no lean back. Big breath in. Exhale, chaturanga. Pull, pivot, plant your weights. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. This one is like not staying in my ear. Sorry, guys, if you're hearing like some feedback. Inhale, your left leg high, please. Exhale, low lunge. Grab your dumbbells. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, warrior two. Pull them through heart center. Micro bend through your elbows. Inhale, reverse warrior. Punch straight to the ceiling above your shoulder. Exhale, chaturanga. Pull, pivot, plant. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Inhale, bend your knees, look forward. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway, no weights. Exhale, fold low, grab your dumbbells. Inhale, chair pose. Chair pose, take it wide. Heel toe your feet out. You've got two pulses into a bent over, wide row. Sink it down, two pulses. Press your weights in heart center. Send your booty back, wide arm row. Sink and pulse for two. Send it back, row. Sink and pulse for two. Send it back, wide row. Sink and pulse for two. Send it back, wide row. Pull towards your hips. Sink and pulse for two. Send it back, wide row. Sink and pulse. Send it back and pull. You got it. Okay, let's wake up through our backs a little bit. Squeeze your shoulder blades to the ceiling. Pull your dumbbells towards your hips. Parallel your belly with your mat. So you are bent over, you can use your back to pull. If you are in chair pose, you get a lot more shoulder. We're not going for shoulders yet. I'll get you later. Micro bend through your elbow. Excuse me, through your knees. You have to bend your elbows. Coffee. Sweet nectar of life. He's like, listen, while you like figure your stuff out, I'm like just sweating a little bit over here. Would you pay attention, please? Got you, girl. Five more. Last three. Two. Inhale, chair pose. Can heel toe your feet back to like a normal position. Exhale, chair airplane arms. Send your hips back. You've got a bent over tricep kickback into a good morning. Bring your dumbbells to your shoulders. Squeeze it up. Send it back. Kick back. To your shoulders. Squeeze it up. Send it back. Lock it out. Shoulders. Squeeze. Send it back. Kick it. Shoulders. Pinch it up. Keep going. Full range of motion tricep love here, you guys. You may get a little bit of bicep love as you bring your dumbbells to your shoulders. That's cool. That's cool. Good morning. See, what's a good morning anyway? With a good morning. So traditionally in the gym, you have like a bar across your back with some weight, and it's for your hamstrings. It's a hamstring and core exercise. Send your tailbone back, glide it back, feel your hamstring stretch like, ooh, and then squeeze forward. Obviously, your dumbbells are way lighter than anything else you would be putting on your back in the gym. So it's not quite so good of a morning. It's like a better morning. A few more here. Three, two, exhale, chair, airplane arms, bend your knees. Inhale, chair pose, keep it narrow, two pulses. Bend over, narrow row. Sink it low. Two pulses. Bend over, narrow row. Think low, two pulses. Bent over, narrow row. Just warming up, just warming up. We're just getting to the things. Lindsay's like screaming for some cardio. She's screaming for it. She wants it so bad. It's coming, Lindsay. For now, I want you to sink your hips in line with your knees. Get low for your pulses. They are controlled. So think less about a bounce and more about a sink and a sink. So you get lower. Lift your toes, dig through your heels. Same rules apply with your narrow rows. Like if you want to take more than one, I mean, go for it. Go for it. But glide your shoulders away from your ears and then pinch your shoulder blades back behind you. Your elbows, your dumbbells will follow. You over this yet, Lindsay? She just made like a, I don't know, noise. Five more. Last three, two. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, forward fold. Ditch your dumbbells. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Inhale, high plank. Let's like move some stuff. You've got a double tuck burpee. So you tuck it in, back, tuck it in, hop, double tuck, plank, tuck, plank, forward, jump, double tuck. It's a double tuck on your mat and in the air. Double tuck, come on. That means two tucks forward on your high plank, two tuck jumps in your burpee, the backside of your burpee. Yes, girl, yes, girl. Look, the double tuck on your feet is just to get you out of your shoulders. Tell yourself it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. This is when Lindsay's very aware of the fact that, like, I'm no longer doing them. No, Lindsay, because I have to survive to get it to the next thing. I'm kind of winded from the two. So good. Look, everything's working in your body right now. Like, there's no escape. Burpees are freaking hard. They're a lot of work. The double tuck ain't helping anybody. Well, it is, though. It is, though. In your practice, it's helping you get stronger, creating endurance. You're gonna burn more calories than the rest of class just by getting your heart rate up. 5 seconds. High plank in three, two. Inhale, high plank. Grab your dumbbells. High plank. Tricep push-up with an alternate kickback. Tricep push-up. Kick back the right. Tricep push-up. Kick back the left. Tricep push-up. Kick back there, right. Continue to go. I like to take my feet wide here, take the rock out of my hips. You can always take your hands off your dumbbells. Another amazing idea is to take your tricep push-up from your knees, friends. You can always press back up for your kickback or just stay here, or just stay here. But do you see how my elbow peeks up above my rib cage? Hello, do that. It's not enough to swing your arm back. Pull your elbow above your rib cage, is why we warmed up with narrow rows, and then kick back, why we warmed up with kickbacks. Just building on. Look, this is like a tricep crusher. This is on purpose. This is your tricep work through class. Like, this is it right here. That means, friends, take a modified plank. When you're over the modified plank, take it from tabletop. You still get the tricep burn. This doesn't need to look like anything specific. You just need to create sensation in the backside of your arms. I want your triceps popping. You do too. And it makes me think of that expression, practice makes perfect. There's like, that expression is super messed up. Because there's no such thing as perfect. And if we're constantly chasing perfection, we will never be fulfilled. So be in this moment, feel the burn in the back of your arms, and know that you are getting stronger. You think you're dying, but your body has never been so alive. Your heart rate's probably still pumping from the burpees. You're finding some active recovery. The sweat should be dripping off your face and you're squeezing out through your arms. Everything's firing, everything's going. You are getting better, you are getting stronger right here. It's worth celebrating. Five more seconds of it. Last three, two, inhale high plank. Get your dumbbells. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale your right leg high, please. Exhale, low lunge, no weights. Heel lift through the front into a T slide with a lift. Low lunge, heel lift. T slide, heel lift. Low lunge, lift your front heel. Slide in, make a T, lift your heel, lift your glute. Low lunge, heel lift. T slide, heel lift, glute lift. Low lunge, lift. Slide to a T and lift. Low lunge, lift. Slide to a T, lift. So you lift your calf to the back of your knee. At the top, you also squeeze through your left butt cheek. So you're making a T with your feet. Making a T, don't overthink it, so that when you squeeze up, your inner thighs touch the top, and then you squeeze. You lift your glute, your shelf behind you. Remember our frog pumps? It's your upper booty. It's your upper booty. It's your back shelf. Don't overthink it. Your quad should be getting kind of pissed. Close. She's like, I'm ignoring you. Gotta focus. It's a lot of balance. Use your core. Hug it up and in. Reach the crown of your head to the ceiling. You get out of this in five. Last three. Low lunge in two. Exhale, low lunge. Grab your dumbbells. Inhale, crescent lunge. I'm going to turn towards you guys. Crescent lunge. Hold your crescent lunge. Bicep curl to a chest press. Lower. Squeeze and curl. Press. Pull it in. Lower. Squeeze and curl. Press. Inhale, lower. Exhale, curl, and press. Inhale, pull it in and lower. Exhale, curl, and press. Squeeze it up. Press it forward. As you press forward, touch the heads of your dumbbells together. Squeeze your biceps into your chest. This is getting you out of push-ups, by the way, so lean into it. Now sink a little lower. I want you to hover your back knee above your mat. Son of a, I know, Lindsay, I'm on you like white on rice. There's no escape. As you bicep curl, squeeze your elbows into your rib cage so you can isolate your bicep. Then you press forward from here. Again, squeeze your biceps into your chest. Ladies or gents, I want some cleavage. Like big cleavage, big cleavage, as much as you can muster. Everybody wants cleavage. Sink a little lower. You get to add your legs in three, two, lower, curl, press up and chest. Down, lower, curl, press up as you chest. Lower, curl, press up and press. Lower, curl, up and press. You're gonna use your exhale for your legs and your chest. Make this active. Perhaps you've noticed that as you press forward, you get a bicep extension as well. So we're talking about your chest. We're talking about squeezing your chest, but you're still burning your biceps. It's an extension. So you're lengthening while you strengthen. This is good for tone, friends. How you doing, Lindsay? Whew. Hanging in there, hanging in there. Just a few more. Last three, two. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, warrior two, pull them through heart center. Hold it here, bring your elbows in line with your shoulders, face your dumbbells towards each other. You've got a 90 degree lateral shoulder raise, flip it up, down. Hug it in, open, flip it up, down. Hug it in, lift, flip, lower. Hug it in, lift, flip, lower. Hug it in, lift, flip, lower. Hug it in, fly it up, lift, lower. You got it. Feel every part of your shoulder. Lift with the top, the medial part of your shoulder. As you flip, you feel the front, you feel the rear. Flip it up. Think lower in your warrior two, please. For three, get at our legs in a military press in two. Hug it in, up, flip, shoulder press, lower, down, hug it in, up, flip, shoulder press, lower, flip it down, hug it in. Whoo! Hello, shoulders! You also get a lovely hold through your warrior two. You get the legs, you get the lunge, but it's delayed. You have to hold it until your shoulder press. Keep going. Think about it, think about it. I know it's a complex, there's a lot of steps here, but there's a lot of steps so we can move it around. So slide a hand. Perhaps that means you can be here longer. I don't know, friends. I mean, really, how many lunges have we done here? Not that many, because you have the hold in between. He's like, shut your face. Just see her face right. She's being a very good sport, a very good sport. Look, I get it. It's a lot harder when you're actually in the work and staying in the work and not doing three and piecing out. Okay, five more seconds. Last three. Two. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, star pose. Ditch your front dumbbell. Front dumbbell's gone. Come into a side lunge to the top of your mat. Side lunge, point your toes forward. Sink your booty down and back. Cross body toe touch with your back weight into a heel click low row. Sink it down and touch, pull it back. Sink it down, pull it in and back. Sink it down, squeeze. Sink it, squeeze it. Sink it, squeeze it. Touch, pull, touch, pull. Get low, explode up. This is fast, friends. Come on, it's cardio. You only have one weight, you're not even lifting it. You're just pulling it. Little faster. You click your heels and step right back out. Click it and step, good. This is to keep you fast. Because if you step your foot down, then you have to reset. You click it and drop. Click it, drop, click, drop, click, drop. Pull your shoulder blade behind you. Pick up your pace. 8 seconds to go, as fast as you can. Come on, Lindsay. She's like, son of a. Last three, two, hold your side lunge, hold your side lunge. Hold it low, cross body toe touch. Take it to a side lunge to the back with a fly. Send your booty over, touch your toe. Send your booty over, fly. Send it over, touch. Send it over, fly. Send it over, touch. Send it over, fly. It's a side to side lunge. There is no stand up. Hinge forward, send your booty back. Parallel your belly with your mat. Now squeeze it up and in. Touch your toe, fly to the back. Front, lunge to the front, touch your toe, lunge to the back and fly. Toe touch, back fly, toe touch, back fly. Keep going. Your hamstrings and glutes should be barking. Sink low. At the bottom of your lunge, this is as high as you get. You fly to the back, skate over to your toe. Fly to the back, toe touch, fly, toe touch, fly. Take it a little faster, side to side, side to side. Now feel your quads light up as well. Oh, four more. Last three, two. Inhale, star pose, one weight still. Exhale, horse pose. Turn your toes forward again, I want you in a wide squat. Sink your dumbbell down. Hold it here. Sink your booty in line with your knees. Front raise, weighted squat jump. Front raise, weighted squat jump. Front raise, weighted squat jump. Raise it, hop, raise, hop. Hold it and raise, hop. More cardio. Yes. Good news. We are over halfway through this thing. This is the end of side two. You just need to push from here. So good, so good. Here's the other kicker. As you practice, as you get stronger, you get lower. Your jumps get more explosive. So you never have that validation moment of like, oh, it's easy now. It's not easy. If it's getting easy, check in. You should be real pissed off. Like Summer, count us down. I will. But I want a bigger hop. In fact, just the hops, just the squat jumps for eight. Come on, friend. Get them in. Point your toes. Four, three. Come on, Lindsay. Two, exhale, horse pose, good girl. Exhale, horse pose. Grab your other dumbbell if you want. Inhale, star pose. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, chaturanga. Pull, pivot, plant your weights. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Inhale, your left leg, inhale, high plank. High plank. We're going from high plank to lifted table. We can alternate with our hands and legs. For now, walk your hands back to lifted table. Walk them forward. Jump your feet to lifted table. Jump them back. Hands forward, feet back. Hands to lifted table. Feet to lifted table. Hands forward. Take your feet. Walk your hands forward, Tuck your feet. Keep going. High plank to your home base. You walk your hands back, stack your shoulders over your wrists. Your hips are over your knees. So good, so good. So high plank and lift the table. That's where you end up. You either get there by stepping your hands or jumping your feet. You alternate. It's a lot of core love. It's a lot of shoulders. A few more. You can take as many steps with your hands as you need, but maybe you alternate which one leads. 5, 4, 3, 2. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, your left leg high. Exhale, low lunge, heel lift, T-slide with a lift. Low lunge, heel lift, T-slide, lift. Low lunge, lift, slide, lift. Low lunge, lift, slide, lift. Low lunge, heel lift, T-slide, heel lift. Low lunge, heel lift, T-slide, heel lift. Keep going. Light up through your calves, your quads, and your back shell. Yes. Come on, friends. We're so close to being done. Like, it doesn't feel like it, but we're so close. Last 3, 2. Exhale, low lunge. Grab your dumbbells. Inhale, crescent lunge. Bring your dumbbells to your side. Face your palms forward. 45 straight arm kickback into a chest raise. Squeeze through your shoulders. Squeeze your chest. Pinch your back. Pinch your chest. Pinch your back. Pinch your chest. Squeeze it back. Pull it in. Pinch it back. Pull it in. Wide. Together. Wide. Together. Keep going. Look, if you're at home, your music's probably a little different. I think we got some skipping action happening. So I'm just going to back up a few songs. That's all we're going to do. That's all we're going to do. Keep going, Lindsay. Sink a little lower in your legs. You get to add those next in 4, 3, 2. Sink it down and back. Squeeze it up. Sink it back. Squeeze it up. Pinch it back. Squeeze it up. Squeeze your shoulder blades together on your spine. Pinch them. Squeeze your chest. Pinch your back. Squeeze your chest. Touch your knee to the ground to keep yourself honest. Roll your back heel over your toe. 5 more. Last 3, 2. Inhale, crescent lunge. Exhale, warrior two. Again, bring your elbows in front into your body. You got a hammer curl to an open rotator. Curl, open. Lower, curl, open. Lower, curl, open. Lower, curl. Keep your elbows glued to your rib cage. Your open is not gonna be all the way. Like, it's not gonna be all the way sideways. You should still be at an angle, like a 45 degree angle in front. None of this, that like hurts things. Hold your lunge, get lower. Bend your front knee 90 degrees. Drop your hips in line with them. Yes. Good, Lindsay. 4. We get to add on our legs in a lat press in 3, 2. Curl, open, press out. Pull it in, lower. Curl, open, press out. Pull it in, lower. Curl in front, open, press. Curl in front, open, press. Curl in front, open, press. Put your elbows behind your back as you press. Open, press it up. Keep going, you're almost there. We just have a few more postures. Remember, core is already out of the way, it's already done. Press your dumbbells out to the side. Bring your dumbbells to like shoulder height only. Any further, you're killing your shoulders. We've already got those. Press them out. Use your lats, your back muscles beneath, behind your armpits. I know you're getting tired. I know that's a good sign. Nobody wants to take class, carve out time, and be like, I feel nothing. Nobody wants to go camping and be like, I still don't get it. Why are we sitting in the dark? There's coyotes out here. Same thing, guys. Stay in it. Five more. Last three. Two. Exhale, warrior two. Drop your front weight. Inhale, star pose. Side lunge to the top of your mat. Cross body toe touch into a row. Touch it. Click and row. Touch. Click and row. Touch. Click and row. I want it fast. As fast as you can go, Flynn. Speaking of friends, I'm seeing more and more come. Class is starting in the other studio. Yay. They're all looking in here like, what the hell? Look, we're just doing the things. Take it a little faster. Come on. Get your heart rate up for three, two. Hold your front lunge, cross body toe touch. Glide it to the back, back fly. To your toe, to the back to fly. To your toe, to your back to fly. Front toe, to the back. Reach across, then pull it back. So good, so good. Squeeze your shoulder blade to your spine. You have to pinch. Parallel your belly with your mat. Pop your booty back. Like, I want to see your booty gains, Lindsay. I do. Don't worry. If you're at home, nobody's here to make it weird for you. Come on. Stay as low as you can. Five. Four. Three. Two. Inhale, star pose. Exhale, horse pose. One weight. Bring your dumbbell to heart center. Got a narrow shoulder press, squat jump, press, squat jump, hold and press, squat jump, hold and press, squat jump, hold and press, squat jump. Create the number 11 with your forearms. Your elbows, your forearms, your wrists are all the same distance from each other. Press it straight up, then hop. Hold and press, hop. Hold and press, hop. Your last bit of work. The very last bit. You got it, girl. Come on. Few more. Just the jumps. Just the jumps for eight. Get in at least eight. Come on. Just jumps. Skip the press. Last five. Four. Three. Two. Exhale, horse pose. Grab your other dumbbell. Inhale, star. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, chaturanga. Pull, pivot, plant your weights. You made it, friends. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Drop to your knees. Swing your legs out in front. Swing your legs out in front. Bring your right ankle above your left knee. Find a figure four stretch. Flex your toes. Press your knee away from your body. You can gently sway if it feels good. I'm on my seat because I feel like I get a better stretch here. I also suffer from cardio. So I'm on my head above my heart. If you're comfortable and ready for it, you can lay down. Lindsay's got a great option on her back. You can reach the keyhole, interlace your fingers behind your hamstring, find a little more leverage that way, whatever feels good. Either way, feel the stretch in your hip abductor, your side booty. Big breath in. Exhale, extend your legs long, switch it out. Bring your left ankle above your right knee. Pull your heel towards your booty, flex your toes. Gently sway. Inhale, exhale, extend your legs long. If you're ready, lower all the way to your back. Inhale, your arms overhead, full body stretch. Exhale, hug your knees to your chest. Gently sway forward and back, rock side to side. Massage through your spine, through your kidneys. Stay for a big breath in. Exhale, allow your knees to fall to the left for a supine twist. Stack your right hip on top. Glue your right shoulder blade to your mat. Feel the stretch in the middle of your back. If you have any lower back sensation, release your heels from your booty, your knees from your chest. Gaze where it's comfortable. Big breath in. Exhale, let it go. Slowly come back through center. Hug your knees in, reset your spine. Allow them to fall to the right for a supine twist. Stack your left hip on top. Glue your left shoulder blade to your mat. Look for the same sensation. It may not be the same posture. Stay for a breath in. Exhale slowly back through center. Hug your knees to your chest. Find happy baby. Grab the knife edge of your feet. I'm gonna do it. This isn't the weirdest thing we've done. As you kick your feet to the ceiling, actively pull with them with your hands. Place your entire tailbone on your mat. Maybe you sway side to side. Rock your baby. Big breath in. Exhale, hug your knees to your chest. Give yourself one final squeeze and release to your Shavasana. I'll pull you out in just a moment. Slowly begin to wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. Inhale your arms overhead. Full body stretch. Exhale, please roll to your right side, supported fetal position. Rest your head on your bicep, curl your knees towards your chest. Take this moment to acknowledge all the hard work you put in on your mat and be so incredibly proud. Know that off our mats, the more we life, the better we get at it. Sometimes we get those moments of celebration, right? There's a distinct like point A and point B, we've made it. But on your mat, the spoiler alert is we don't usually have that. Progress is gradual. Doesn't mean it's slow, but it's small. And each day is different. But know that progress is being made. Because as you get stronger in your practice, you get physically stronger. You get more confident. Your form gets better. You sink lower. You go faster. You get more reps in. Your muscles are more efficient. It feels harder. It never gets easier because you are getting stronger. So please don't discount this time you put in. Please know that it's supposed to feel hard. If it feels hard, you are doing a lot of things right. Slowly press up to a comfortable seated position. Your eyes can remain closed. Inhale your arms overhead. One last stretch. Exhale your hands in through heart center. Excuse me. You, my friends, are so freaking strong. You are worthy. You are enough. And your presence is needed here. We seal our practice with namaste. Thank you for joining us, you guys. Hope you have a fabulous rest of your day, evening, all that jazz.